Edo State. And it takes a while to think of the gains of democracy in the last 4 years. With a long and enviable history as one of the oldest and most highly developed states in Nigeria, Edo is now a shadow of its former glorious self, as most of its teeming youths are unemployed. All but a couple of the state's tertiary institutions have been shut down, and industrious market women striving to provide for their families are constantly thrown into prison for the slightest infringement of government policies. And this is just scratching the surface.
As I call the gome, I wait, I see a wheelbarrow. As I hope wheelbarrow, now Abasaki people come. They sell for Nioba Palace. Now I say, lai. I know they sell for Nioba Palace. Now I they wait, memo to cross, make I enter. Now I they see myself. They call the portier gas, put for my face. They call the portier gas, put for my face. Now I they see myself for Benin prison. My blue shirt now, where? They say that I pay 100,000 or I stay for 3 months. Now I say, I'm not thief. I don't do anything. I don't kill anybody. My 4 children now I get. Now, I don't get what they do again. See my leg when I take go beneath prison. I know they feed the worker. I don't buy medicine for 40,000.
You know what you are about to say? You do not make them say we not go come out again for them. Because I don't to go Oko. I go Oko for common live where they say I spent 10,000 naira. Where they ask me say, are you guilty or not guilty? For front of gates, yeah, for Bobiswa Road. That one na walk away. He said, center of road for ghost here. They collect 10,000 naira from my hand.
I they sell for us, upper market, now upper market. Upper market now they sell. I hang my anki, my pampas, everything for my gates. Not be even walk away. Now upper seki people come, they carry me go front of Oko, front of a court. They say, man, they talk. I started the talk. They say, whether are you guilty or you not guilty? And I say, I'm guilty. Then they carry me for say Oko. They carry my loads. I can't pay 15,000. They collect my loads. I don't see anyone not correct. The second time again, they still carry them again for my gates. 3 times they carry my load. My load not the correct. They will carry me go Oko. I go pay 10,000. The small load where they carry it, 5,000. I don't see anything. I pay 5,000 for nothing. I don't want to go Eko again.
Since November 2016, Edo State has had the misfortune of being managed by a governor who is detached from reality. He carries on like an emperor, ruling from his imperial throne over unsuspecting people who actually are his passport to power.
Abaseki na failure, na promise and fail governor. Some of the PDP people, what they see, the question why they always ask them. If you say Abaseki won, this one at the level. Man appoint Abaseki project. He report can make the show us for this what the level. If we turn anywhere where we look now for level, what the level, but they see Oshomole handwork. School, road, Abaseki, you know, get one way you do for us.
In Benin City, several markets have been raised by fire within a short space of time. After each incident, the state governor would visit and promise 100 million naira to ameliorate their suffering.
In this state and in this country, what kind of government that don't think? Hey?
I don't approve. Say, make una give me the list of everybody. Where una know? Say, they really trade for this market. Us, as government, we go put today 100 million naira to compensate una.
We were able to meet with the government. We wrote a letter and submitted it to his office. So today we are trying to organize ourselves if we can go to the government to know if they are doing anything in that regard.
Since where government promised us, he only promised with maths. He never give us any money. He never give market leader the money at all. He only use maths tell us. And as the market born, everywhere you see now shortage. People where we borrow money for, no fee give them. People where give us load. No say that time at Christmas season. We no set the load. Talk less of to balance the money.
Till date, none of those promises has been fulfilled. One of the markets that was burnt to the ground is the Ekusa market. The government is yet to make good its promise, which was made in December 2019. On the 9th of September 2020, the market women resorted to obstructing vehicular movement on major roads around the market to get the governor's attention.
Market got burnt on the 22nd of December. Our Excellency Governor came and promised that he would give us money to wipe away our tears.
And our store burnt. Since December, we not see money. Okay. Me money. See another form I go collect again.
500. We collect form again.
500 again. Now I tell you they collect form. Contract form. They are form there.
They say they give you 9,000 naira.
No, so people. I not see 1 naira. Yeah, no road again. I not see 1 naira.
I just a market the same provision. First stop, my first stop, I bomb. But money back first stop. Oh, but what is another move 1 naira? Carry form come. Trust form. They carry a come. They say we come fill up. That's my coffee trust fund. Say now, and I borrow the one borrow us the money. Then we bring BVA. When they come tell me that one, I say, I less big money. I also come borrow money. We are what they pay.
Protests have become the order of the day in Edo State, as staff and students of the College of Agriculture Igworia have taken to the streets more than 10 times to protest the sack of all the staff of the institution, demolition of the school buildings, and unpaid salaries since August 2017. Students of the institution have been forced to stay at home since then, their education suddenly truncated. The frustration led one of the students to take his own life.
These are classrooms for ND1, ND2. This is chemistry laboratory equipment where all chemical analysis, soil testing, proximate analysis are carried out. This laboratory was also equipped, was also renovated and equipped by the Edo CIFOR in December 2014. As you can see, everything has been completely vandalized and destroyed by Governor Godwin Obaseki. So if you are telling Edo people that you are doing well, or you want to build a school, must you destroy what you have?
Vision and mission for the Edo State College of Agriculture Igworia here is not different from every other colleges of agriculture in Nigeria, solely for the production of middleman power in the agricultural discipline and other related fields. For at the end of the day, a degree or certificate is awarded in ND National Diploma Program or Higher National Diploma Program, solely in the field of agriculture. So it's purely a training and research institution. I challenge Governor Godwin Obaseki to tell Edo people how much investment he has made into these tertiary institutions. I mentioned about 5 tertiary institutions. Without fear or favor, let him come and to tell us how much investment he has made. In Igworia, for instance, everything we got was through personal effort, through international donor, like Edo CIFOR, and we went borrowing. And it's also sad to inform you that I went into the bush to cut log, saw it into a finished product to construct benches and desk for chairs for the students in a government institution. So, as far as I'm concerned, there is no funding for these institutions. The last subvention we got was, as it was approved, about 6-7 years ago. And on a yearly basis, we normally appropriate additional money for the budget of the college. For instance, on a yearly basis, the House of Assembly was always giving the college additional approval of about 5 million naira. I also challenge the present government to tell us how much of such money was released to the college. So throughout the 4 years of Governor Obaseki, there was no 1 month an overhead was released for that college, for the College of Agriculture. So how do you not expect such college to run? There was no overhead. I have. There is a duly approved by the former governor of the state for the college. When Governor Obaseki came on board, he stopped the overhead for the college. Is that not an indirect way of killing the institution? So there has not been funding. But unfortunately, I must not fail to tell Edo people that even when Governor Obaseki closed down the college in August 2017, in 2018, there was budgetary provision for that college. Go to Edo State for a budget, as approved by the Kangaroo House of Assembly. In 2018, Governor Obaseki budgeted 360 million naira for the college. And overhead cost of 32 million naira for the college. In 2019, Governor Obaseki approved the sum of about 560 million naira for the recurrent expenditure for staff salaries. In 2020, he also approved the sum of over 560 million naira for salaries for the staff of the college. And both capital provisions were also made in the current budgetary provision for Edo State.
And none of this money came.
So the question is, staff have not been paid for the past 3 years. There is budgetary provision to pay staff salaries as approved by the State House of Assembly, as indicated in the budget. So what now happened to the money?
If you say that we are not qualified, I can tell you categorically, I have more than 50 of my students that I have trained from that college that are working in this ministry, and they are very productive. I have some of my staff who are working in Okomu, who are working in rubber research, some of my students, they are very productive. I can tell you that. As we speak now, the governor has decided to conduct computer-based tests for new employees in that college. However, even with a court judgment, which for us is contempt of court, he has refused to implement. And I've told the Commissioner for Justice, I've told the Commissioner for Agriculture, that CBT test that they are conducting is not avoid. That is just the truth. We have lost some of our staff. We have lost some of our students. Mr. Obaseki, the governor of Edo State, is not a man of his words. While he was campaigning, he promised 200,000 jobs. But what are we seeing today is even sacking the one that he met on ground.
Other state-owned tertiary institutions that have been shut down by the Obaseki-led administration include the College of Agricultural Technology, Agenegbude, the College of Education, Ekiadolo, the School of Nursing, Benin City, the School of Midwifery, Benin City, the Institute of Continuing Education, also in Benin City, as well as the Michael Imodu College of Physical Education, Afuze. The Ambrose Ali University, Ekpoma, escaped the hammer, but the institution is on life support as it has been left to generate its own revenue after the state government drastically slashed funding.
Or some of your daughters or some of your sisters, they are students of Ambrose Ali University. I used to give them 270 million every month to support them to pay their teachers and non-academic staff. But the has reduced it to 96 million. In July, they borrowed to pay. In August, the bank refused to borrow them, which means that university will again be closed. If a nation is losing the progress, or a state is losing the progress it has already made, is it difficult for you to understand that Obaseki has put a door on reverse gear? We are now in the minus. You go to a school, you find two teachers. And Obaseki says he's doing a dope best.
He's a scam.
Using consultants.
Listen to the affairs.
Do you use consultants to train teachers?
No.
Teachers are trained in a structured university where graduates are produced, or college of education. But you know how much is paid per student, per teacher? 1.5 million for a 4-week program. 4 weeks. With 1.5 billion, you can pass to the University of Benin, and you have Bachelor of Education.
Of course.
Everything Obaseki has done is fraud.
The storm water master plan, which was initiated by the Kamuri governor to deflood Benin City and its environs, has been abandoned. It is now commonplace to see flooded streets and neighborhood when it rains in the metropolis these days.
Been at number 15, Arusha Street. Arusha Street. I'm a pressman. For now, for the past 6 months where this election is coming, we cannot even enter our house. As at now, we are begging the government to help us come and do the drainage. To come and do the drainage, to help us. Some money assets now. You can see what I see now. So many people are outside. We don't know where we want to sleep this night.
Several times, government have come to this country, apart from Oshomole, who has done us what we ever expected. The Obaseki regime has never, he taught us a lesson. He came here. He saw what the water did to children. What was his response? Up to now, nothing.
In the area of road construction, there has been very little improvement from where Comrade Adams Oshomole left off in 2016.
Obaseki. With motorcycle,
okay.
You should through this place.
Okay. Someone like I'm Obaseki.
Yes.
Not true.
We talk because I was a labor general secretary.
Okay.
Inside labor congress, I was there. Okay. He knows me.
Okay.
We met in Yola conference.
Okay.
And Maduguri conference.
Okay.
So otamai igba vanya ye motorcycle reni.
Okay.
Then the other one, he had it 2 times.
Okay.
My office.
Okay.
But here, I'm aware. Of you, you talk where. He said, yeah, yeah, more Obaseki does say, wow.
Okay.
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 Yasese.
Okay.
Where is Obaseki?
Same goes for the building and equipping of primary and secondary schools. Comrade Oshomole championed the Red Roof Revolution, which has now been consigned to the dustbin of history.
Sir, they do my primary school echo. Just look at the surroundings of a school. Should we not weep for Edo State?
Of course we should.
Should we not weep?
We should.
And somebody is telling us Edo best.
Because none of you are picking it up.
Come and look at Edo best under Obaseki.
Apart from increasing the taxation burden on the citizens of this state, in that sector is called a distinction. Taxation. Promise of 200,000 jobs. Provision of pipe-borne water,
Amen.
Road construction and rehabilitation.
Amen.
There was nothing to celebrate because he has done nothing. And from all indication, he will do nothing.
While the Edo State governor has failed woefully in improving the standard of living of the citizenry, he has done amazingly well in the area of signing memoranda of understanding. Most projects he claims to have executed have only actually been completed on paper, with the most recent MOU signed on the 7th of September 2020. This explains why he is called the MOU governor.
He lacks leadership. And he also lacks the temperament, the patience to be able to rule over a people. He's deceitful. I can't say that.
The second term bid of Governor Godwin Obaseki, which he thought he had in the bag, is fast slipping through his fingers. And as the trajectory of the election reveals that the odds are against the incumbent, his frustration quickly turned into anger.
Very clearly, and I told my cabinet yesterday, second term for me is non-negotiable. I am demanding it because I deserve it. I think I've earned it.
You know, you will mobilize for yourselves.
Yes. 4+4.
Nobody has monopoly of violence.
Yes.
If they want violence, we will show them violence.
Yes.
So if I see anybody, if you see anybody smashing any cars because my sticker or poster is in the car, let us know and we will show that person that we're government. We will show them that we are in government.
Yes.
And I am governor Philip is deputy governor. We are the only two who have immunity in this state.
Yes.
We are the only two people today who have immunity in this state.
Yes.
And I am sending a very clear warning. Very, very clear. If I find anybody misbehaving, no matter who you have been, I will arrest you and I will deal with you.
Somebody will be national chairman, though we don't suspend that now. So now we have said, until he take permission from the governor, he cannot come to Edo State.
Apart from picking a fight with his predecessor, he prevented 14 duly elected legislators of the Edo State House of Assembly from representing their constituencies for over 1 year.
The law provides for how a house should be proclaimed transparently the day we are announced. Members elect are informed of the date and time for inauguration. These are clearly spelled out in the Nigeria Constitution. And just last week, you were all witnesses to how President Muhammadu Buhari issued proclamation letter to the clerk many days before, stated date and time for the inauguration of the two chambers of the National Assembly. Even while we are still negotiating to ensure that, you know, our party was not divided on the floor of the House. Without prejudice to the outcome of those negotiations, the President issued proclamation because he's obliged by the Constitution to do so, whether he likes it or not. And he did, and did it transparently. He has led us by example. For me, it is very embarrassing if any state governor, particularly of APC extraction, will do anything that is less than what the Constitution says and the example that our President has set. So, you know that what happened in Edo is that they did not publicize any proclamation letter. The members were not informed. They do the inauguration at 9:30 p.m., what in the Supreme Court judgment they call nocturnal hours. Business of Parliament are done transparently. They are not secret court. Now, you have 24-member house. 19 members protested. You have six. You carry people with their short knickers. Even in the house, they have rules. They have dress code. So it's happened in Edo, it has happened in Bauchi, like Edo, Bauchi use a minority of 10 to go and convocate or proclaim a house and lock out 20 APC members and God do tell people to elect, exactly the way Edo did with six, and then co-opt other three people to become nine. But even at that, it's not safe for us. These are completely illegal.
Several well-meaning Nigerians and institutions tried to intervene the entire time, all to no avail. Mr. Governor rebuffed all overtures for peace, including the effort made by His Royal Majesty, the Oba of Benin.
We are so happy because we have a proud father, which is His Royal Majesty, the Oba of Benin.
Oba, so
today, we know he has said before now that there should be peace in Edo State. We are also joining that voice to call for peace. However, we are not saying Your Excellency should become a puppet. But what we are saying here is that we have to look back and remember our campaign promises. One of the campaign promises is simply we will bring development to Edo State. We will bring development to every nook and cranny of Edo State. But in an atmosphere of imbroglio fighting, it is not possible.
Felix Shuaibu, that I always call my son, but I'm not sure whether I will call you my son again the way you have been going. Philip, they say you are the tough one inside. You must believe. Please. Tell your boys, if it's you, tell your boys to cease fire that your papa has told you to. They should cease fire. Enough is enough. I don't want to hear shootings, guns anymore. Enough is enough. Don't want to kill yourselves because of office. Because office will be dead. Life will be dead. Well, even if you don't win, there will be other things God has proposed for you. Maybe even greater things. Must it be a do or die affair? Your Excellency, the governor of Edo State. Enough is enough. Me, I'm very, very sad and upset about what has been happening in Edo State lately. I think this must be the worst scenario from all the politics that we have been seeing in Edo State.
I'm not happy about this
when you didn't let me resolve the issue between you and your friend, comrade, before it got to this point. If we had done it that time, we would not be sitting here and everything would have been smoother than this.
The 2020 governorship election slated for the 19th of September is offering the people of Edo State a fresh opportunity to rewrite history. It is a new dawn with the emergence of Pastor Osagie Ezeyamo, the candidate of the All Progressives Congress. His campaign has taken the state by storm and he is surely coasting to victory.